You just gotta eat it. Sis, you gotta eat it. Don't take it personal. I ain't lying. Hey beauties, how y'all doing? I am Lissa and this is Life with Liss. Welcome back. For those who are subscribed, thank you so much. And for those who are newly subscribed, welcome and thank you so much. If you are seeing my face, this face here for the first time, go ahead, like and subscribe and hit that notification bell so that you can be updated for more videos to come. Okay, cool. Y'all, the story just keeps unfolding. As I said in the last video, we're gonna keep getting these pieces and these slices of the pie of what's going on with Patrisse Cullors, what's going on with these missing funds. Here we are, this just in. Let's see, y'all. I just want to thank you for everyone who is new, for everyone who is newly subscribed. Thank you so much. I really appreciate the support. Y'all, we are really growing and I really am thankful to each and every one of you. Y'all are the reason why I do this and I'm very grateful for the opportunity to share my opinions with y'all. Thank you so much. I love y'all. Let's get to it. Tax filings reveal how BLM co-founder spent charity funds. Black Lives Matter co-founder Patrisse Cullors used charity funds to pay her brother and child's father eye-watering sums of cash for various services, according to tax documents filed with the IRS. The co-founder's brother, Paul Cullors, saw a cool sum of $840,000 hit his bank account for allegedly providing security services to the nonprofit organization, tax documents seen by the Post show. Okay, I actually read in a different article, because there's been a slew of them, that he's actually a graffiti artist. Why is he getting this sum of money for providing security? Especially when, what's her name, showed up at your house last week? What's her name? Candace Owens showed up at her house last week and she said the security that was there was white. So your brother ain't white. Meanwhile, the organization paid a company owned by Dana Turner, with whom Color shared a child, almost $970,000 to help produce live events as well as other creative services. On top of the controversy, BLM wrapped up its fiscal year, which runs from July 1st, 2020 to June 30th, 2021, with a stunning $42 million in net assets. The foundation had an operating budget of about $4 million, according to a board member. More than $37 million was spent by the foundation on grants, real estate, charter on private flights, according to the tax filings. What, they need to be all private? Private flights for? You know, sometimes with humanity, what I really understand is they probably didn't expect to see this huge amount of money. And then once they saw all these zeros, the dollar signs flashed in their mind and something said, this is mine. This is mine to do with as I please. It's greed. What's more, $32 million was invested in stocks, making up nearly a third of the $90 million the organization received in donations. The investment is expected to become an endowment in a bid to ensure the foundation's work continues in the future, organizers say. The 63-page Form 990 document, an annual filing required for nonprofit organizations to maintain their tax exemption status, shows Colored reimbursed the organization $73,523 for a charter flight. Why do you have that? Why are you spending that much on a charter flight? Like, this is just ridiculous. Again, you see the money, you see in this just... And it's time to attack. It's time to spend it all. No. BLM says she took the flight in 2021 out of concern for the COVID-19 pandemic and the health risks that come with it. Excuse. Cullors already found herself in hot water after receiving a cool $120,000 payment for undisclosed consulting fees. What? By BLM. But the other thing that I just read before actually coming on this video. Ooh. Y'all saw Sebastian in the back, my cat in the back. That scared me for a sec. Woo, Chile. BLM co-founder Patrisse Cullors says her mistakes with white guilt money were weaponized against her. you know, being that I really keep, I am paying so close attention to this Amber Heard and Johnny Depp case, and seeing a lot of how people are interacting or people are dealing with things today, really not wanting to take accountability for their stuff and just own it, just eat it. Like, we're human beings. We're going to make mistakes. We're going to slip up. We're going to do things that are not 100% right, because that's a part of humanity. And also a part of that is accountability. I mean, I just don't understand. Girl, what? This title upset me to the thousandth degree. White guilt money? Let's read into this. Black Lives Matter co-founder Patrisse Cullors said that when $90 million in white guilt money came pouring into the organization's coffers after the murder of George Floyd, the group had no infrastructure in place to handle the flood of cash, and now the mistakes made are being weaponized against her. This is synonymous. I think that's the word I want to use. This is the same thing, synonymous with what is happening with Amber Heard. You've been caught, girl. It's clear. We keep coming up with bit and piece of all this stuff that you have wrongly done with this, with these funds, with this money. Now is not the time to talk about white guilt money. Now is not the time to blame someone else. Now is the time to eat it. Now is the time to take it and deal with it. You can't place the blame anywhere else. Your name is all over it. You're shelling out money to your friends, your baby daddy, your brother, your cousin, your uncle. Girl, you have to own it. All this placing the blame somewhere else just makes it 10 times worse. I really don't understand that thinking. I would just say, yeah, I did it. And I'm sorry. And I would start selling the properties and stuff if that was me. I mean, if that was me. If you're using them for parties and stuff like that, you don't need the properties. I would just start getting rid of all the stuff. Anyway. I know everybody ain't like that though, clearly. I'm a human being that has made mistakes, that want to change, want to challenge those mistakes, and want to learn from those mistakes. Okay, cool. Cullors told the host of MSNBC's Into America podcast Monday. And I think what's been hard is feeling like there isn't room and space for that. If you would own it, if you would just spill the guts, make it clean, take ownership of your actions, there would be space. There would be forgiveness. Not everybody is going to forgive you, but that's not the point. You need to come clean. You need to come clean. It's unfortunate that it's happening in the public space, but you wanted your face to be out there. You wanted to be known as one of the co-founders of BLM, to be speaking up about how Black lives truly matter and how we need to abolish, she's an abolitionist, get rid of all of these systems in place and all of this other stuff. You were so loud about that, and now you're not loud about your wrongdoing. You're not loud about owning that, but expecting grace. You have to just spill it. Otherwise, people gonna keep applying pressure. Because it's in a public space and people can do whatever they want if it's out in the public space. The beleaguered former executive director of the Black Lives Matter Global Network Foundation, woo, mouthful, also addressed this allegation that she had personally benefited from the donations by purchasing homes for herself, including a $6 million property in Los Angeles, which included a 7-bedroom mansion, a pool, a soundstage, and a garden. This was an investment, she said. It's not my personal real estate. It's not Patrisse Cullors' real estate. It's the organization's real estate. Cullors said the house was to be used as a media creation space for BLM and also a safe house for activists. But she said the organization decided to stay mum about the true purpose of the mansion out of fear that the right-wing media would jeopardize the safety of those associated with the movement. No. The Black Lives Matter founders only care about the Black Lives Matter founders. They don't care about Black lives in general. We have seen that. We are seeing it clear as day. That money went for selfish reasons, for personal reasons, and none of it was given back to the community. None of it was given to help any Black community. Now, I don't need to really read more of that. Honestly, what I wanted to say is what upset me about this was this headline and her using these words, saying the $90 million in white guilt money. Girl, don't label the money anything, because this is the money that you decided to spend wrongfully. White guilt money? These words, you're trying to trigger people. Nah, it's not working, because a lot of Black people donated to the organization. You bamboozled a lot of people, Black, white, Asian, it whatever color, you bamboozled people. You just gotta eat it. Sis, you gotta eat it. We are human beings. We are going to make mistakes. I think that there is grace in accepting that there is a mistake being made and doing what's right to fix it, adjust it, make amends with it, instead of just trying to kind of make it go away without offering up anything. That's not right. It's not okay. And until she does that, I think she might still get some heat. Yeah, that's all I gotta say about this. Y'all really let me know what y'all think about that. Thank you so much for everyone that commented and saw the last two videos. I really appreciate it. Let's keep this thing going. Like, subscribe, share. I love you, beauties. Love yourself, love others, always. Bye, beauties. Don't take it personal.